Today we're going to use Tinkercad to make a fantastic hex fidget, so let's get cracking. Start by visiting Tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. It is a website, so you never have to install it. Using Tinkercad, you can make 3D designs, circuits, or code blocks. Today we're going to make a 3D design, so simply hit create 3D design. I like to start by naming projects. We're going to call this one Hex Fidget. Once you press enter, it is immediately saved. These are some of the basic shapes we can build with, and the one we're going to use today is the polygon. Now, when you drag this out, you can move it around and set it down when you're finished. Notice I am lining this up with the center of the grid lines. That just makes life easier. A little later, I do want to highlight that they have properties. You could change the sides and the segments, and you could even add a bevel. Right now, though, I want to just show you how quickly this saves. As soon as you build, it automatically saves to the cloud. If you click back to the Tinkercad dashboard, there is your project. It is initially private. Right here, you can click and make it not private. You can duplicate it. You can check the version history. You could also add it to a collection. We're not done with anything yet, so we're going to simply hit Tinker this so we can get back in our project. The first step of this project is to understand the measurements of our shape. Right now it's 20 on this side, which means across these points right here, and it's 17 across the flats. We're going to hold down shift and grab one of these corners, stretch it to Crazyville, and then I'm going to tell you to type 10 for the distance across these corners, which gives us the 8.66. I also want this to print in about an hour, so we're going to change this height to 20 and press enter. I'll show you how to make yours larger at the end. It's super simple, but this lets you get a small one printed so you're sure that you built your connections correctly. Now I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. Notice if you go inside this circle here, it's 22.5 degrees per turn. If you hold down shift, it's 45 degrees per turn. All that did was get the flat so it was aimed forward for me. I'm going to quickly grab this now and get it centered on one of the grid boxes. Once again, that just makes it easier for the other parts we build. The first part we're going to build is a tab that'll stick out. Grab the sketch tool, bring it out, and set it in a 20 by 20 grid. Notice that center line matches just like that. Now when it opens, if you've never seen Sketch, I will remind you of the Sketch features. All kinds of great information in here. Check it out. Teaches you how to be smarter as you build, and they update it all the time. To close it, you can simply click here. If you prefer my tutorials, I do have a playlist. I will put a link to it right up here. Let's start by making life easy by making our nudge 0.5. Click right here, close to one of these corners, and we're going to make a part that's 3 by 1.5. Notice we can see those dimensions. And 1.5 by 3 and 1.5 and 1.5. Now when we double click on this, we can grab these two points, and we're going to move them in 0.75. To do that, we're going to switch to the 0.25 and just click three times. 1, 2, 3. Then we can also grab these two and move those in 1, 2, 3. We have just built the awesome connector that's going to stick out and hold our part together. Now we can hit finish sketch and make a couple adjustments. First, we're going to set the height to 12. This is how far it's going to stick up. Then we can grab the shape, do L for align, click on its center, and we want it to be lined up center. And I'm also going to put it to this edge. To move it to the correct location, I'm going to go back to my 1 millimeter nudge, and we're going to nudge it out 2 clicks. That is going to be the part that allows this to slide in just a little bit. Now we're also going to use this part to make the groove that they sit in. To do that, you're first going to do Control D. I'm also going to set the color to green just so it kind of stands out. And we're going to edit that one. Notice if we hide the green color, you can choose Edit Sketch. Now what we're going to do is make this 2/10 larger in every direction. So once again, we go back to our scale, set it to 0.1, double click on it, and then simply grab these two and go over 2 clicks. Grab these two and let's go up 2 clicks. Now I'm going to grab just this one and go over 2 clicks. Notice this doesn't match up quite right, so I'm going to go 3 clicks. Let's do 3 clicks this way. grab these two and go two clicks to the right. And then finally these two and go two clicks back. So we're just making this larger in every direction so that there's a gap. When you're done, you can hit finish sketch. Now this one has to go almost as tall as our project. We're going to leave 1 millimeter on each side. So instead of 20, we're going to make the green one 18 and press enter. We're also going to turn it into a hole. Now we're going to move this to the opposite side of the project. Start by hitting T for transparent. Then we're going to put the work plane back here. Hit W and click. Now we can click on that hole, find the cone, and drag it out a long ways. But then we're going to simply type the number 9 and press enter. I'm going to put the work plane back down on the ground. You can see how this piece is going to slide into the neighbor piece right there. Now the 9 that we drug it was to get it past this 8.66 part so that they line up. With those aligned, we can move to the third part. Once again, it is going to be sketch. You can set it right out here in the 20 by 20. Notice it's harder to line up if I don't have the 1 millimeter nudge on. Now it goes right to that spot where we want it. For this one, we're going to make sure we've got our nudge set to 0.5. We're just going to click on one of these corners and we're going to move out 12. That matches this pin that we designed. We're going to go up 2 millimeters, and then we're going to go in 4, over 4, and connect it. Once again, if you double click, you can check your dimensions, 4, 4.47, 4.47, and 12, and then hit finish sketch. Now we need to maneuver it for the correct direction here. First click on it and simply do flip this way, so you've got the top aimed that way. Then we also need to rotate it 90 degrees so it's standing up. Finally, let's hit D to drop so it's standing at the right location. Now we can shift select these two, choose L for align, make this one the boss, and bring it to the center. At this point, we're going to use the awesome intersect command. I'm going to shift select so it's easy to grab just those two. And if we do control I, bang, we have got the cool shape that is going to make this whole project work. Notice what it did if we open this up. These pieces out here that are not touching and these pieces out here that are not touching, they disappear as that part is created. How cool is that? Now we can grab our parts, do L for align, and we need to simply click on the big one to make it the master, and we want those to all be centered. As you can see now, there's going to be a top, a bottom, we've got the slider, and the hole it connects in. We do need these connectors on every side. We're going to do that by simply bringing out a tube. I'm going to tell you to make the radius 20, and then we are going to shift select the tube and the large piece. L for align, click on that hexagon. Make sure it is centered and centered. This part is kind of slick. We're going to use this tube to rotate these perfectly. I'm going to use shift select to grab all three. And then when we do control D, notice I'm zooming out so I can see that handle. I'm going to rotate it, and I'm going to rotate it any number of degrees, but then I'm going to type 120 in this box. Because there are 360 degrees in a circle, you just do control D one more time, and our parts are on every spot of that. I'm going to delete these, and you can see how they are on every face. We can now grab them and do control G to group. All of a sudden, especially if I hit T to shut off transparency, notice it did take two clicks, you can see the hole where these pieces are going to connect on the other one. Now let me show you how we get these put together. W for work plane. Click on this face right here. Control D. And then we're going to grab the cone, pull it out to any number. Notice it was 13.66. But then we're going to type the number 9. Do not touch anything else and do Control D three more times until you have 5 of them. W for work plane. Put it back down. And we are almost done. The next step is to put the work plane on this side. W for work plane. Click on that flat piece. Grab them all and do Control D. Once again, pull it out however far you want, but then type 9 in the box and press enter. Control D three more times, and we've got all our parts. W for work plane, these three are not needed. Notice I'm just carefully touching the edges, making sure it says 3 and hit delete. Once again, just touching the edges, making sure it says 3 and hit delete. That's our fidget. Final step is to trim these off. We're going to do that with a cool technique. Switch to orthographic or flat mode. Let's quickly grab them all, switch to top view, and hit F for fit view. Finally, T for transparent. And then if you zoom in just a little bit, check out that view. This is a good time to make sure you did not make a mistake. If you did this perfectly, you will see that there is a gap everywhere around those parts. Mine has the gap, so I'm happy. Now we can start trimming. Check it out. It is as simple as this. Double click to edit. When you get the pink area, we just want the ones that are outside gone. So click delete, click delete, click delete. Click out here to finish the edit. This piece is now finished. Simply move to the next piece and double click to get in edit. Notice this one only has two pieces. Delete, delete, because these are all connected inside. Double click to edit. Continue that all the way around. You will notice after a moment, it is always 3, delete, 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 finish, and then the next one will only have 2. It's an easy pattern, and as you can see, it only takes a moment. And there we are, all done. Once again, double check to make sure you've got all your little parts. Everything's got its little edges. I'm going to switch back to perspective view. Zoom out a little bit, make sure it looks good all the way around. It is easy to forget one of those. I'm going to hit T a couple times to get it back to solid. And let's export this one for 3D printing. Once again, export. Selected shapes. Notice there's 19. STL. I store mine in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm going to change this to be Hex Fidget 20 because, of course, you can make them different heights. I'm choosing 20 right now because it prints fast, which is great for your first test of the project. So I've quickly bounced to Bambu Lab Studio. Let's hit Create New Project. Of course, I'm in my 3D modeling folder, and I want the Hex Fidget 20. I'm going to show you 0.2 standard. We are using generic PLA. I am going to go to speed, and I'm going to make sure this is set at 0, and we're going to slice the plate. Notice it's going to take about an hour and 10 minutes. I'm going to zoom in on this, and I just want you to see as well. When we look at this from the top, I'm going to zoom in, and you can see all these little gaps. If you ever had it so it did not have the gaps, that would signify you've got a problem. This is a great way to check and make sure that nothing is running into each other as your part is getting printed. I did actually already print this, so I'll show you that in a moment. First, I want to also back you up to prepare, and let me show you the difference if you bring in the larger one. Once again, it was Hex Fidget 40. I'll show you the 0.2 standard. If we slice that plate, it is going to take an hour and 58. If we switch to 0.24 draft, once again, slice plate, it cuts it to an hour and 43. While that's printing, let me show you how to make a taller one. Simply grab your middle post, do Control D, shift nudge to move it to the other side. Now, of course, we need to ungroup it. Then we just need to pick the height. Say you wanted to go to one that prints a long time, like 40. Then you can simply grab these parts and adjust them as well. This distance would become 38 instead of 18. And then we do need to align everything again. L for align, make sure you pick the hexagon, and we just want them to be to the middles, just like that. Grab that and do Control G to group. Notice we grabbed the middle because we've got all the pins. I'm going to do the T for transparent to get it back to a solid. Let's move it over here so we have a little bit more room, and then simply repeat the duplicate, nudge, and of course, delete steps. And of course, T to double check that you've got all your gaps. Ready to print, back to perspective mode. I am going to do the transparency, and I'll send that one to the printer in a minute to show you how long it takes as well. And not too much longer, we have got a fidget. Let's take it to the other room, and let's test it. Alrighty friends, so this is the fidget. As you can tell, they do not move initially. You need to push them just a little bit. But as soon as you start wiggling, they snap free. And in a matter of minutes, you've got a fantastic fidget. Now, as you can see, this is the longer one. Of course, here is the smaller one, printed fantastic as well. Of course, depending on how long you want to wait for them to print, you can try whichever style you like. Alright, so as I wrap up, a massive shout out to ZDP189 working with me to come up with this technique, which I think is absolutely fantastic. Being able to draw with sketch lets us be so precise. Notice if your printer cannot handle the 0.2 gaps, you can simply adjust to a 0.3 gap all the way around where I had done the 0.2 one. Of course, then you just adjust your other measurements until it works the way you want. Notice if you're printing at your house, you can make these take as long as you want. As a classroom teacher, I needed these to be done in about an hour because when you've got 100 students, you needed to be just a little faster. Finally, friends, as I wrap up, I do want to say thanks to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. I will remind you, of course, there are members-only posts. Make sure you check those out as well. Also, a massive shout-out to my Patreon supporters. It is a fantastic group. There are more than 300 members. It is a fantastic free messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, post designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.